What's good, y'all? Vibe with me for a minute. Mastering your thoughts. We got to start looking at thoughts as glue. A flavor of glue that sticks to you whenever you think that what that thing is true. Look at what it do to you once you start thinking about it so much that it becomes the embodiment of you. That's what I'm saying. My bad, y'all. I be going off on the rhyme sometimes. Just trying to find a meaning to your own design of what the fuck I'm trying to say. The thoughts that we have around us, they all, depending on what you are attracted to. You know what I'm saying? Anybody having thoughts about just drawing and shit? You might have an attraction to certain cartoons. You might have an attraction to certain pencils, charcoal, different kinds of lead that you can use to do your thing. So, just being in the element of those things, that just being who you truly are, you almost innately, you always attract those kind of thoughts about how creative can I be today? How much devotion can I place on this thing that I love? Well, if you're not doing that, you're gonna be stressing. You know what I'm saying? You're gonna be feeling unfulfilled, feeling like there's so much more for you to do. Like you ain't playing your role. You know what I'm saying? Those are the kind of thoughts that come along with being, I want to say immature, but just like you haven't learned to tame these kind of thoughts around you. And once you start thinking that you are certain things, like I said, you become those. You know what I'm saying? If you saying things like, I am mad, I am sad. I mean, looking at my hand right here, this is the entity, the essence of the frequency of sadness. And depending on what I got going through my day, it attracts to my aura, my biomagnetic field, depending on how I'm vibing with it. If I'm on a higher vibration, this shit can't catch up with me. It stays away. But the lower vibration I get, this sadness or this thing that deals with my lower nature, it attracts to my body even more. You know what I'm saying? Going through my aura, that's when it becomes quickened. But the higher vibration that I got, no, this entity of sadness is going to repel itself. You know what I'm saying? Our overstanding of it will then happen, which is we see sadness, we see that the essence of sadness for what it is, and it serves its purpose just to allow us to feel what it's like to be in this humane state. Like I said, unfortunately, we think that our own vessels, our own entities, our own feelings, are these foreign, expressions. And these expressions, like I said, just like people, it's like food. You come to know them, taste them, let them be. And a lot of these thoughts, especially if they ain't serving your purpose, especially if it has you attracting such an imbalance in your own life, sometimes you really gotta cut that shit off. And these thoughts, like I said, they're like glue. And if you say that you are those things so much, I mean, that's what causes things like trauma, depression, PTSD. Those kind of, because those thoughts have stuck with us so much. Even when we shouldn't be thinking about those things. It's always in our subconscious. Your subconscious is within. It's within your darkness. So you associating so much negative experiences, low vibrating experiences, with what's within. You think that shit is you because you are filled up with it. But you gotta have the will to stop feeling that way. Or pay attention. Feel. What are you filling yourself up with? What kind of thoughts do you got sticking to you? Deal with them things. Like verbally address them shit out loud. Talk with them about people and get that shit out your system. Make a song about it, draw about it, and then move on to something else. You got to expose certain things about you sometimes just to like let go of the seriousness of it. That's what makes a lot of the thoughts that you have is kind of like dull over time, because we pick up brand new things a whole lot, and we start like, damn, got a new PS4. I'm just gonna start playing that thing. But after a certain amount of time, I mean, what happens? You, at least over here in the West, with the Western way of thinking, where we have such a low appreciation for things, you, after a certain amount of time, you're like, you start getting into that pattern. Just because it became your pattern, you kind of bored with it now. Bored with the PS4 or the Xbox, the Nintendo Switch, eat, especially when it comes to food that you love. Bored eating this kind of ice cream, bored eating this kind of fruit all the time. Those same things can happen with the thoughts of trauma and depression. I know that it seems more difficult when we personalize ourselves, fill ourselves with these negative experiences. But trust me, I've been through all of that shit. I'm just trying to give you a way out, or give you the imagination to do so on your own. Because we don't come down here with manuals and shit, man. The ancestors of the past, they put that shit on walls. They ain't talk about jobs and shit, 9-to-5s, all the mundane things that we be doing nowadays. That shit is about death. In order for you to not let these thoughts be glued to you at the point of your death, you gotta confront them things. Let it go. That ain't you. Now, if something that you want to continue on doing your soul journey, shit, by all means, do whatever the fuck you want to do. But for those who have no understanding of what these thoughts mean, and you need certain wording for or whatever, I'm here to tell you, it ain't that deep. And in the way it is, but also in the way it ain't. You know what I'm saying? But your thoughts. Master them things. You don't have to become them. But you can see them for what they are. You can feel them for what they are. You can taste them for what it is. But understand that is just an expression. And expressions. Hey. Some people idolize expressions. They idolize Jesus. They idolize Martin Luther King. They idolize Tupac Shakur. They idolize Beyonce. Those are expressions, and they become personal about it. It's where now, they attracting those thoughts, man. I remember lyrics, Tupac, Bone Thugs, Outkast, all of them back in the day. Me growing up without a pops, no bigger brother, all the time, it was pretty tough for me. So I had to like. Shit, growing up here in South Florida, trying to find your manhood, you do that shit with music, you do that shit with sports sometimes. Especially me being a so-called young black male, you gotta find whatever I can find. So, with the development that I've had with the kind of thoughts that I try to attract outside of my own depression and the traumatic experiences, all them shits, they happen, but shit, in a way, they still kind of became or what I was now, or how I express those things, but not to the point where it's determining a negative path for myself, a path where I'm like, I'm unsure of what's going on, or I don't know why what's going on, I don't know why I'm doing this. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people are like, damn, why I did that? I've been telling myself that less and less, and that's the voice within, the intuition that I'm speaking of, I've been telling myself this less and less. Cause I mean, those are the thoughts. So I mean, I know what I'm doing. I know. Shit, man. That's as far as, all right, back to the thoughts. As far as the thoughts that I needed to have resonate with me more. You know what I'm saying? Stages of enlightenment and shit like that. Go from understanding, all right, Christianity is bullshit. That Hebrew Israelite shit, no bullshit. That Kemetic shit, bullshit. That a lot of what y'all call astronomy is astrology, bullshit. I see them things for what it is. Now, if you had once I called all that shit bullshit. You know, if you had a skipped heartbeat or something like that, and you're like, hold up, don't say this, don't say. See, that's you filling yourself up with that bullshit. Not to say that those stepping stones are bullshit, because they get you to a certain place if you need a certain kind of training and prerequisite for your own soul or whatever. But all that shit is really subjective, man. All that shit is really just for one's own experience. Shit, there's a certain way that I eat, that I used to eat. I call that shit bullshit. But that shit was what I called me at the time. But I can't be the shit here. I can't be the shit if I'm like trying to protect what I eat for using my ego or whatever. Being like damn, fuck y'all thoughts. My thoughts are the superior ones. I'm saying that's not shit. I say that to an extent just to, you know, I mean, let y'all know, because sometimes you be like, damn. I know people don't understand me, but they ain't supposed to. I'm one who understands thyself, overstands thyself, understands thyself, all that shit. So sometimes I gotta remind myself to be doing that, just so that y'all know. Sometimes I gotta come back and remind y'all. But I mean, anyway, things gotta be confronted, addressed, and seen for what they is. As far as the thoughts are concerned, they had to. You just gotta let things be. You know what I'm saying? People be thick skin. Well, that shit is real. Your thick skin gonna keep you here. Your thick skin is gonna keep all those negative vibrations on you. Saying, shit, my bad. I was saying thick skin, thin skin. You know what I'm saying? If your vessel ain't up to par to like what it's supposed to be, it's gonna be negatively affected. You wanna be in control of your own domain, your own dome, your own thoughts. You know, you gotta tell all that. And I mean, it just gets deeper and deeper, but then again, more shallow and shallower, depending on what kind of perspective one is having when addressing one's own thoughts or one's other thoughts. So, just keep that in mind whenever you feel offended or feel like you got to defend. You know what I'm saying? Look at that shit from third person perspective sometimes. And take that to a 6. You know what I'm saying? Take that to a 8. Dealing with your time. Take that to a 9. all that spiritual shit is aligned. I hope one day you find, or whatever it is that's taking over much part of your mind. I understand that you are sublime. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. Sante Sana. One time for your mind. All right, y'all. Peace.